Morning everyone, I welcome you all in science class students. Students, today we are going to discuss about the parts of a cell. So in my previous class we have discussed about different types of cell, how it vary by its size, shape, numbers, right? And today we are going to discuss about the parts, means each cell have certain parts, certain specific parts, and each part perform specific function. So let's discuss. So first one is cell membrane. Basically, cell membrane is the outermost covering of a cell. Yes, cell membrane is the outermost covering of a cell, and it has a porous and permeable nature. Means porous means it has some pores on it, and secondly permeable means it allows the movement to go and out, allow the movement of a substance to come or go out from the cell, right? So cell membrane is the outermost covering of a cell, and it allows the movement to come inside or go outside from the cell, right? And it also gives the shape to the cell. Like some cell do not have any specific shape, it doesn't mean their cell membrane is not present. Their cell membrane is present, but their cell membrane is elastic, right? This one is the cell membrane, and it is present in that animal cell, plant cell, whether in microorganism, bacteria, algae, fungi, right? Next one is cell wall. So cell wall, basically it is only present in the plant cell, not in any other cell, like in plant cell, fungi, certain bacteria, right? This cell wall is present only in them, right? It is not present in animal or any human cell, right? So basically cell wall is the hardest covering of a cell, and it is after the cell membrane. It is located after the cell membrane. So basically, why plants only have a cell wall? Let me tell you, plants need to stand upright position, and they need to bear all the environmental stress. They need to bear up all the environmental stress. So for that, they need certain protection. For that, they need mechanical strength, right? So cell wall basically provide the mechanical strength to the plant, and it also protect the cell from the harsh climates, right? Next one is cytoplasm. Cytoplasm is basically a jelly-like substance that is present inside the cell. It is between the cell membrane and the nucleus. Cytoplasm is the jelly-like structure, or you can say substance, that is present inside the cell. And basically the function of a cytoplasm is to it release or store the energy, and all the metabolic activity of a cell occurs in the cytoplasm. This is the function of a cytoplasm. Next one, that is the most important part of the cell. The most important part of the cell is nucleus. The most important part of a cell is nucleus. It is a dense-like structure present inside the cell. Nucleus is a dense-like structure, round dense-like structure present inside the cell, and it controls all the activity. That's why it called as a brain of a cell, because it controls all the activity of the cell. Second thing, the second most important or important crucial role of nucleus is that it inherit the characteristics. So there is one substance present inside the nucleus that inherit the traits to their offspring. So let's discuss more about the nucleus first. So basically nucleus also has one outer covering, and that outer covering is known as nuclear membrane. The outer covering of a nucleus is known as nuclear membrane. But there are certain kind of cells which do not have their nuclear membrane. So we'll discuss about them in our next class. So in plant cell, basically nucleus or plant or any animal cell, they have the nuclear membrane, right? Then its nucleus has the nuclear membrane, right? Your nucleus has the outer covering, and that outer covering is known as nuclear membrane. So inside the outer covering, there is one dense like structure present, right? So that dense round like structure is known as nucleolus. What it is called? Nucleolus, right? And that nucleolus is made up of a long thread, and that thread is known as chromatin. That thread is known as chromatin. So let us suppose this is the nuclear membrane and this is the chromatin here in the nucleus. So there is a space left between the nucleolus and the nuclear membrane, and that space is filled up with the jelly-like structure. But that jelly-like structure is still not, it's not called as a cytoplasm. It is present in the nucleus, so it is known as nucleoplasm. So plasm, something word like, just remember, plasm means jelly-like structure, right? So I hope you have understood about the chromatin. Chromatin is a long thread-like structure. So in my previous lecture, I just told you about cell theory, and in third part or third key point of a cell theory is that new cell arises from a old cell. So whenever any new cell arises from a old cell, basically this chromatin has some crucial role in it. So basically whenever any new cell arises, this chromatin form into a rod like structure, and that rod like structure is known as chromosome. And each chromosome have different sections, right? And each sections are known as genes. Genes are the unit of inheritance, means they inherit the traits. Means the you already listen that word, that is called heredity. Heredity means something which you got up from your parents, right? My eyes look like my mother. So why? Because of the genes. Because of the genes which I inherited from my mother, my eyes look like my mother, right? So genes is the basically genes are the unit of inheritance, and it is made up of DNA, right? So we will discuss about this thing, and it is very important because this part will come into your next chapter, that is reproduction. Next one is, we have discussed about chromatin, nuclear membrane. The next one is vacuole. So vacuole is a sac-like structure, and this sac-like structure larger in plant cells and smaller in animal cells. Why plant cells have larger vacuoles? Because they need to store food, they need to store waste, they need to store water. So basically the function of vacuole is to store the food, waste and water, right? Next one is Golgi apparatus, mitochondria. These two are also cell organelles. So cell organelles means parts of the cell. The last one is plastids. Plastids and cell wall. Let me remind you one thing, that cell wall and plastids both are only present in plant cells, right? They both are present in plant cells. And let's discuss about the plastids. Plastids, basically in the plant cell there is some color bodies present, and that color body which have a disc like shape are known as plastids, right? So basically there are three kinds of plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast, right? Chloroplast, have you listened that word? We have already discussed in 7th class. Chloroplast, in chloroplast, chlorophyll is present, right? The green pigment that is known as chlorophyll, it is present in the chloroplast, right? And chloroplast is a green color plastids, right? And here we have discussed all the parts. So I have a model with me, and here you can see the model. So basically here you can see this is the outer covering of a cell. So that is known as cell membrane, right? And Next one is blue color. Have you seen that blue color layer inside the cell? So it's a jelly like substance, and that jelly like substance is known as cytoplasm. So I'm keeping it here, this stick. Next one is nucleus. Nucleus is basically a round like structure present inside the cell. So here you can see. So here inside, you have seen this thread like structure, and I told you what we call that thread like structure. That is chromatin, but it is present in nucleolus. So I am keeping it here, I am pasting it here, this. So that thread, that dense thread like structure is known as nucleolus, and threads we call it chromatin. And this next one is this matrix like structure, this is called mitochondria. And here you can see this one is the Golgi apparatus. So I hope you are clear with one more thing which I left, the outer covering is known as nuclear membrane. So student, I hope you have understood all the points which we have discussed so far, and I'm sending you the keywords along with this video. Just go through the keywords, learn that keyword, and try to write in your own words, right? And there are some keywords which I haven't written in the notebook. What you need to do is that you have to write that keywords in your own words. Thank you, and have a nice day ahead.